guys, and welcome back to Anime First Looks. And today we're going to take a look at a series that is available only on Amazon right now, and that is Beatless. Now, this series is where it's talking about a lot of what's the word I'm looking like want to use here? It's automatons. Basically, we have these androids that look really human, and basically, you know, they do the random, you know, the odd jobs that no one else really wants to do. Granted, they do, you know, stuff from cooking and, you know, helping out, taking care of someone who is old, elderly, to, you know, fashion models and stuff like that. So it's a widespread, the automatons basically go widespread, but a lot of times with the series, though, itself, after watching the first episode, it's okay. It's not great, it's not terrible, but it's just okay. And really, the series itself draws parallels to plastic memories. And anybody who knows what my thoughts were on plastic memories is I absolutely really like that series because it takes a look, deep dive into, you know, something that is using something like automaton who has very limited life. Now, granted, this one here, the only parallels really is not because this android has limited life. It doesn't have that. It doesn't have that speciality there to, you know, get you, maybe something bad might happen here, I'm not sure. But basically, this guy basically treats these automatons as if they're human beings. And that's kind of really where the parallel between between Beatless and Plastic Memories are. Because after that, basically, you know, Plastic Memories is dealing with cancer, basically all these terminal illnesses of having to get over with a loved one and everything else, the pain that's there, and that's the reason why I think Plastic Memories is such a super strong series, and Beatless is just kind of there. I mean, some of the other stuff, the colors in the animation do pop. The animation is really well done. I don't think I really found anything too annoying with this animation and how they use, I don't think they actually use any CG, which granted you can tell if they use CG or not because let's face it, it's one of the main things that they love to do is use CG. And not in the series, but in most series they tend to use CG as a reliable background source for crowds and all that stuff. So far I've not seen any, I think there might have been some, but I'm not really sure though. Now, granted, as I've made through the series so far it really hasn't had too much for action-wise, but when it does get into the action, it's pretty standard what you'd expect from an action anime, with just some really fun sequences of, you know, seeing her, the choreography isn't, you know, that's okay. That's the thing, that's my issue, I think, with this series, is that it's just okay. It's not really on the tail end of, say, something like Katana Maidens, where you can kind of see where the story's going. Granted, this might go to the point where, you know, she winds up getting with an automaton, robot, whatever you want to call her. basically, he's going to wind up, you know, having to get in trouble with the state. We've seen this plenty of times before, where he kind of gets roped up into multiple other stuff. I mean, you see it in Siren, you see it in Burst Angel. There's a few other ones out there, too, as well, where basically the guy gets kind of roped into it and not really wanting to get roped into the mess he's put into, but he kind of has to deal with it. So, with what my thoughts are on, you know, I've seen a few of the episodes. It's okay. I'm going to continue watching because I kind of enjoy the characters in it. But really, to be honest with you, for it being a Amazon exclusive, is it one to get Prime for, if you like, for this one series alone? No. I don't think the series is worth getting Prime for just this series. Granted, if you have access to Prime, I'd definitely check it out because it's not, as I said, it's not terrible, but not great. It's kind of stuck in that mediocre slide, which a lot of series is, unfortunately, run into that. Now, granted, this season has been a lot of good series and series that I would find, you know, this is actually interesting, or this is, you know, I kind of like that. So you're going to see a lot of stuff, you know, on this, you know, when we do a top 10 list finally, you're gonna see a lot of like Beatless might get on there, may not. As I said, it's gonna be a tough list to come up with because of the fact that there has been some really good solid series, and Beatless may not make it because it's just okay. Now, granted, if it's your cup of tea, and you want to watch an automaton, you know, animation, which one's a lot better? Which is available on Crunchyroll is Plastic Memories, is available on Crunchyroll. And also, another series that is really good as well, is available on Funimation, I believe on Crunchyroll as well, is Planetarium. It does a lot better job of what I think Beatless is trying to do with, you know, trying to get us caring about this automaton. And granted, right now, I just don't know if there's anything that's really, what is really at risk right now in the series. So far, nothing's at risk, and nothing really makes me care for these characters. So, yeah, with that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching, and as always, I'll see you guys on the flip side.